We have often asserted, and we affirm it yet again, that no fact in history is better attested than the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. It must not be denied by any who are willing to pay the slightest respect to the testimony of their fellow men. That Jesus, who died upon the cross and was buried in the tomb of Joseph of Arimathea, did literally rise again from the dead.
We're calling out to every nation to spread the word that Jesus is alive. We're people of his kingdom. His resurrection is our freedom. For every heart, every tongue, and every tribe, we will dance with the one that shines brighter than the sun. We lift our eyes. Yeah.
see the light. I tried but couldn't find it.
Yeah.
Then the darkness went away. Someone who knew the truth shine their light my way. God's word is a lamp, a light unto my feet. The truth has been revealed. I am now complete, so I can shine.
Hey kids, have you ever heard the story of Doubting Thomas? It's right there in the Bible, and it has a great lesson to be learned from it. Thomas was one of the 12 disciples of Jesus.
I'm Thomas!
So Thomas was one. Can you name the other 11? There was Peter, Andrew, James, John, Philip, Matthew, Thaddeus, James, Simon, Judas, and Bartholomew. So those guys had it pretty cool, right? Walking around with Jesus, hearing his stories, watching his miracles. Which miracle would you have loved to see? So okay, here's the thing about Thomas. Thomas had a famous nickname. How about you? Do you have a nickname? Do you like it? How'd you get it? So Thomas's nickname, you know what it was? Doubting Thomas. He got that nickname because of one little thing he said. You see, after Jesus died and rose again, he went to see his disciples to tell them that he was alive. But Thomas wasn't there, so he doubted their story.
They told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he replied, "I won't believe it unless I see the nail wounds in his hands, put my fingers into them, and place my hand into the wound in his side."
That makes sense, right? Wouldn't you want to know if Jesus is really alive? I mean, what if the disciples were just joking around? Here's the thing. Jesus didn't get mad at Thomas for doubting. Some people think that Jesus wants us to be perfect, but we're not. And neither is Thomas. Jesus wasn't worried that Thomas didn't believe him at first. He was still really nice to him, and he gave him a chance to see for himself.
8 days later, the disciples were together again. But this time, Thomas was with them. The doors were locked. But suddenly, Jesus was standing among them. Peace be with you. Then he said to Thomas, put your fingers here and look at my hands. Don't be faithless any longer. Believe.
My Lord and my God.
Jesus loves it when kids believe in him, even though they've never seen him. The real lesson of the story is for us today.
Jesus probably isn't going to walk in your house and let you touch his hands.
He asks that you believe in him, even though you've never seen him.
That's called faith, and Jesus loves it when we have it.
Then Jesus told him, you believe because you have seen me. Blessed are those who believe without seeing me.
Doubting Thomas got another nickname that day, Believing Thomas. What about you? Do you believe in Jesus? Why don't you talk about it with a teacher or parent?
I believe.
One of the 12 disciples, Thomas, called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, we have seen the Lord.
Unless I see the scars of the nails in his hands and put my finger on those scars and my hand in his side, I will not believe.
A week later, the disciples were together again indoors, and Thomas was with them. The doors were locked, but Jesus came and stood among them.
Peace be with you. Put your finger here and look at my hands. Then reach out your hand and put it in my side. Stop your doubting and believe.
My Lord. And my God.
Do you believe? Because you see me. How happy are those who believe without seeing me?
In his disciples' presence, Jesus performed many other miracles which are not written down in this book. But these have been written in order that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through your faith in him, you may have life.
Breathe and leave a trail of We lift our eyes up. Let's hear it for these kids. Get them here.